A very warm welcome to all the listeners of Animal Radio who are tuned in to this live press conference coming from Animal headquarters in Monrovia. Today, we have with us the special representative of the Secretary General, Karin Landgren, who just returned a few days ago after briefing the UN Security Council about Liberia's progress and animal's transition. So she will brief you about her interaction with the Security Council. May I turn over the floor to SRSG Karin Landgren.
As Matthew has said, I recently returned to Monrovia from a Security Council meeting in New York on March 20th. This meeting was taking place at the midpoint of UNMIL's current term or mandate. As you know, UNMIL's current mandate started last September. So the Security Council had before it a report from the Secretary General dated February 18th, updating on developments in Liberia and in UNMIL. I would like to share with you briefly five important points. The first important point concerns Liberia's security situation. And Liberia's security has remained generally stable during this period. The situation along Liberia's borders has also remained relatively calm. There have been positive developments within the country, across the border with Côte d'Ivoire, and I'm referring in particular to the meeting last October in Zouedrou that brought together traditional chiefs and elders and many others from both sides of the border, and was attended by President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf and President Ouattara of Côte d'Ivoire, and also the development of a regional security strategy among the countries of the Mano River Union. All these developments are warmly welcomed by Liberia's partners. I've spoken to you before about the challenges of mob violence in Liberia. That is one that has not gotten better during this period, and also sexual and gender-based violence. Also, we don't have good news to report there. As well, there's periodic violence related to concessions around the country. And with regard to concessions, the UN believes that the government can do more to have consultations and information sharing with all affected communities. I also reported to the Council on demonstrations and strikes that the country has experienced. The second issue concerns good governance and important reform processes in Liberia, where there are many challenges. And it's the view of the UN that these reforms need to be pursued with greater urgency. I want to say a few words now about these governance and reform issues. I was pleased to report to the Security Council on efforts to secure greater public accountability. And these efforts include the work of LAC, the Liberian Anti-Corruption Commission, the work of LATI, the Liberian Extractive Industries Transparency Initiative, and other measures that have been taken with regard to irregularities, such as the suspension of forestry private use permits in some cases. Liberia can't afford to have its population believe that allegations of corruption would go uninvestigated and that investigations wouldn't be followed by any consequences if there is a finding of guilt. It's particularly important that these positive developments are also reflected in the natural resource sector, including the consultations with affected communities that I mentioned. In terms of major reforms that are mentioned in UNMIL's mandate, namely supporting constitutional reform, decentralization, and national reconciliation, progress is very slow. Several initiatives taking place in this area are almost entirely dependent on donor funding by Liberia's international partners. Regarding national reconciliation, the Pallava Hut program was launched by President Johnson Sirleaf 6 months ago, but there is no concrete progress in implementing it. This was just one of the recommendations of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission, as you know, and it's contained in the National Reconciliation Roadmap adopted in Banga in December 2012 and launched last year in June. The National Reconciliation Roadmap as well has been almost exclusively funded by the international community. The Secretary General's Peacebuilding Fund has disbursed or committed over $11 million for a two-year period. So here we would like to see more operational capacity and stronger political will from the government of Liberia, including the disbursement of the funding that has been allocated in the national budget, which is $500,000 currently, but which has, I'm told, not yet been dispersed. This is very important if there's going to be progress around the reconciliation roadmap in the next few years. These delays are also true of constitutional review. The timeline that was adopted by the Constitution Review Committee was to complete civic education and public consultations by the end of March, so by the end of last month, and then to have a national conference this month to validate the proposals that that committee is going to make to the president, to present to the president, which would then go on to the legislature, be considered by the legislature, and as you know, there needs to be a 12-month gap between the legislature's conclusions and these proposals going to national referendum. So time is becoming very tight if Liberians want to see changes to the 1986 Constitution within this time frame. The UN has strongly encouraged the legislature, the executive, and all Liberians to reflect together on constitutional reform possibilities. You have right now a unique window of opportunity if you want to see changes in your constitution. Let me turn now to my third point, which is on the security sector, in particular the police. As you know, some very important steps were agreed at a security sector reform meeting last September. These included professionalizing the police by appointing senior officials from within the police ranks, and increasing transparency in the way tenure and appointments are decided by the police. The LNP and BIN as well have been working to become more effective institutions. So it has been quite frustrating to see that the facilities vacated by UNMIL in FOIA, which were turned over to the government and were to become a BIN training center, still not employed for that purpose over 1 year later. Also a new LNP training center in Harper, which was inaugurated last September, still standing idle. Over the past few months, though, the government has made several significant commitments to strengthening the security sector, and I want to tell you what these are. One is that the Minister of Finance has been personally involved in trying to make it easier for funds related to this UNMIL security transition to be dispersed, to be given to national security actors. I'm not sure this has had measurable success yet, but we look forward to good news in this regard, and we appreciate his involvement. Right now, the Police Training Academy has over 1,000 recruits waiting to start training, and over 250 people ready to graduate, but being held up. Second, the President herself has committed to activating more training resources and better use of training facilities. And third, the President has also committed to having a better balance in Liberia's next budget, 2014-2015 between investments in infrastructure and investments in security. UNMIL will continue to offer our support and to work with the many partners that are contributing to the security sector. Going now to my fourth point, the first justice and security hub is operational in Banga, and the courthouse will be inaugurated soon. It's scheduled for April 28th. That is the last facility waiting to be inaugurated at that justice and security hub. Services are starting to be rolled out in hubs number 2 and number 3 in Harper and in Zwedru. And the government of Liberia is to maintain the functioning of these hubs. So these are recurring costs. These will involve recurring costs that need to be maintained and budgeted for in the national budget. There are other important actions awaited in the justice sector, also for the public to have confidence that the courts work and that they work impartially. While the courts continue to develop and expand across the country, it's important to work on alternative dispute resolution mechanisms, also known as ADR. There are trained mediators and others in several counties who are working to help people settle their disputes amicably, in a friendly way, without going through the court system. Recently, I visited one of Liberia's land coordination centers in Harper, and there are 6 of these centers across the country, and heard from 2 people about their long-standing dispute, which is slowly being discussed and settled between them with the help of the LCC. They also pointed out to me that this process is free, which makes it very attractive. The Ministry of Justice has started nationwide consultations to develop a national alternative dispute resolution policy, and this is an important development. Finally, as I reported to the Council, UNMIL's drawdown has continued smoothly, and I expect to report back on this to the Council in more detail later this year.